Hey everyone, welcome back to Urban Rush. Now, Inxs were in town not too long ago. JD Fortune tore his ACL, but performed despite the pain and the brace.
No, and I have to say, when I first saw the reality show that they were replacing the lead singer of Inxs, I thought he was irreplaceable. They have done an amazing job, an amazing comeback, and Darren Maharaj got the chance to catch up with two of the originals, Jim and Tim Ferriss. Here they are.
Falling asleep at the wheel again, baby. We're here with Inxs with two of the Ferriss brothers, and we're wondering, where's everyone's favorite Canadian rocker right now? What'd you guys do to JD?
We just sort of took him outside and gave him one, two, three, you know.
A little dust over.
Is this all part of the initiation for the rookie?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I suppose that there must have been some beer spilt on the stage floor or something, because he went
Yeah, he did and, the old...
He landed on a bad part of his leg, and now he's a little bit worse for wear. Your hands are tight, but you're losing grip. Quickly
fix me, can you read the signs? Yeah, because I heard for the past couple of shows, he's actually been on stage with a cane and a knee brace.
Yeah, totally splint but his whole leg, but he's shattered all his ligaments around his knee. But, you know, he's been a trooper. He's like, he's almost Australian.
The doctor said you can't do that, and he's like, well, yeah, you're fired, basically. JD's sort of adapting with his cane, and he's, you know, I think he'll probably keep it forever now, I think, you know.
Yeah, he probably will.
It's going to become part of the routine. All right, now tell me, now that you guys have the Canadian as part of the trip, do you find yourself every once in a while saying, hey, John, hey, Tim, you know, are you saying hey at all? You're watching more hockey?
A little bit.
Yeah, Tim does more than I do.
Yeah, I get to it just before B. actually, I should say it's not a purely Canadian thing. It also happens in New Zealand as well.
Hey.
Oh, really?
Same in New Zealand. Hey. Well, we got JD speaking Australian now, so.
I have you?
But he's done it with his own, you know, volition. He basically is, oh, nice.
Next thing you know, you're going to have him drinking bitters, eh?
No.
No? That's only kept
what
for the pure.
That?
Actually, I just tried it the other day. Victorian bitters or something?
Oh,
it's a beer.
VB.
Yeah, VB. Okay, see.
Come on.
When JD first came out on the show, Rockstar Inxs, did you guys sort of have a gut feeling going, that's the guy? That could be him?
You know what? We tried to keep it as real as possible. And no, we didn't really. We all had our own feelings about different people. And we never actually discussed it during the whole course of the show until the second last week. Yeah. And it was like, well, I guess, you know, then it became apparent. And when he wrote Pretty Vegas to Andrew's music, we all set up and took notice of that. Mm. And he was, you know, kind of the bad boy as well. We were kind of attracted to that. So
it all sort of fit into the puzzle there.
And another cool thing about, for me too, was that the fact that it was a show based in Hollywood, in Los Angeles, but the rest of the world could vote, like Canada, and it had Canadians in it, and Australian in it, and American, so it really was kind of international. You know?
Well, it had a global appeal.
Yeah.
Now, okay, let's be honest for a second, fellas.
Sure.
When you finally said, okay, this is the guy, you're part of the team now, mate. See, I'm doing the Australian thing.
There you go.
What sort of initiation went down? There must have been something.
Well, we did. I mean, what we did was we got JD in a room, we locked the door, had a couple of bottles of champagne brought in, and we just popped the champagne. We all got in a group huddle and just said, okay, you know, this is a band, and whatever happens, you know, in the room with six people in this band, that's where it stays, basically.
Nice.
And then we did some really weird shit.
Wait, Twister.
So hopefully that no one will find out about that.
But we also then initiated him by, I guess, baptism of fire, you might want to say.
And it's like, now we have to do some press. So we left the room and went into this huge, big, what they call a press junket, where there's like probably 100, you know, meters of just people with, you know, cameras, and JD's there sort of going, and we're all talking, and everyone's talking to different, you know, networks, and then he comes up and it's CNN, he goes, CNN, oh my God, it's CNN!
This is CNN.
Because he hadn't been watching television.
Or Shaw. Shaw's really important too.
I know, but Urban Rush. Because to JD, to CNN, CNN. Yeah. You know.
How much have you seen JD grow and learn from you guys being on tour?
A lot, actually. I mean, to be honest, you know, he hadn't made a video before. You know, for instance, we've made something like 80. So, you know, that was kind of interesting.
So funny.
And, yeah, stop laughing, okay? We'll have to take you out. No, I'm just kidding. And you know, like, just things like that. So in a way, it's been really wonderful for us too, because we've sort of seen things through his eyes, which were really kind of innocent in a way, you know. And he's gone from living out the back of a car to, you know, like private jets, you know, first class, you know, suites, hotel suites, you know, I mean, all that sort of stuff.
And then the stuff you guys are used to every day.
And a touring bus instead of a car. So in a way, it's been, we've been able to see things through his eyes, and he's doing the same through us, so it kind of works both ways.
What would you say has been the most memorable experience so far? I was thinking memorable, maybe it's sort of like the idea of like women breaking into the hotel room and like chasing you down the hallway.
Well, that happens every night.
I guess
it's hardly memorable.
Oh, that.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Is it really that extreme, you know, all the stories that people hear about and the stuff you see in movies and, you know?
Well, if we sometimes told you, we'd have to kill you.
That's what I was afraid of.
It's sometimes quite memorable.
Yeah.
Okay, last question for you guys, because I know you gotta get ready. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Have you heard the talk about the movie?
Yep.
They're talking about doing a movie on Michael Hutchence with Johnny Depp playing the lead and also with Kate Moss.
You know, at the moment it's like, you know, we're getting sort of broken signal. We're waiting for some information on that. That's, we don't really know. We're trying to get to the bottom of it. And
that makes sense.
Sounds
fun.
Great.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so they're both friends of Michael's.
So. Yeah.
So you guys think that would be a great idea?
Sure.
Well, it's bound to happen at some point, so, you know, embrace it, I say.
So with Johnny Depp and Kate Moss in there, who do you guys see?
Playing me.
Exactly.
I was thinking Jim Carrey.
Somebody stop me!
Really? Jack Nicholson?
Nicholson, hey!
Here's Johnny!
Alright, listen, guys, thank you so much for taking the time to chat with
us. Thanks a lot.
And if you can give it a little shout out to our friends Mike and Fiona.
Hey Mike, hey Fiona. We're gonna bounce back to you at the studio.
Back to you, Mike.
You're breaking up there.